Hello students, the second device that we get to use while doing practicals in class 11 is the usage, the screw gauge. Now screw gauge is the second experiment also in the lab that we perform, and again this is being used for the measurement. Earlier in the first experiment we learnt about using a vernier caliper, now we use another device called screw gauge. Now how is screw gauge better than vernier caliper? If I ask you to find the diameter of a thin wire, then it is not possible to use a vernier caliper and find the diameter. So what is a better option? The better option is to look for another device which has more precision and can give you the diameter of the wire quite accurately. So the device that we come across now is the screw gauge. Screw gauge looks something like this, right? So in the screw gauge, this is the rotating scale. Okay, and it has 100 divisions. I'll just take a close-up and show you. This is the main scale. This is called the ratchet. And these are called the two heads between which we place this thin wire. This is an acrom wire that I have taken. So, first thing that we do is to find out the least count and then to find the zero error. Because screw gauge, when you buy, it's very rare that it is going to be without an error. So we must learn to find out the error in a screw gauge. First thing, to find out the least count. To find out the least count, first you need to find out the pitch. What is the meaning of a pitch? Just, it would be better visible from the diagram. It is the distance between two threads. Okay, threads on the screw. So that's the linear distance that we are going to find out. Now how do we do that? First, adjust the screw gauge till you hear the clicking sound, and after that notice the reading which is there on the screw gauge. Yeah. So you can see it is slightly below zero. So now you start rotating and remember to come here only. Can you see it's three divisions, four divisions below zero? Below zero meaning, see, from zero, left side of the zero, that is the meaning of below zero. Now give it, one rotation, two, three, four, and five rotations, and you can see on the main scale it has moved by a distance of 5 mm. We are here from 0 to the 5th division. So like this you calculate the pitch. It would be linear distance moved by the circular scale, which is 5 mm, divided by number of rotations. So that gives you the 1 mm, which means the distance between each thread is 1 mm. After that, once you know the pitch, then the least count will be pitch upon number of divisions. Now see again, the number of divisions on this circular scale starts from 0 and goes on till 70, 80, 90 and then 10 more, which makes it 100. From 0 to 100 divisions we have, right? So pitch upon number of divisions, 100 millimeter, 0.01 millimeter, which is equal to 0.001 centimeter. So you can see the least count of a screw gauge is better than that of a vernier caliper, which is ideal for measuring the diameter of thin wires. Even the thickness of your hair can be measured. Now coming next to find the zero error. Zero errors in any screw gauge are of two types. Either they are negative or they are positive. So negative zero error would be when the zero of the vernier scale does not coincide with the zero of the reference line or the main scale. If, see from here, I'll rotate. If you can see, the zero goes to the right of the main scale. Then we go by the formula of number line, and this zero error is called the negative zero error. So in the diagram, you can see it's three divisions below zero, which means the error in this case is minus 0.03 mm, millimeter, right? for a positive zero error, the zero is below the main scale reading, or you can see there's already a reading there in the device. So in this case, there are two divisions, which means once again, the zero error in this case would be 0.02 millimeter, but it is positive. So plus 0.02 millimeter. Correction for any reading will always be having a sign opposite to that of zero error. So if my zero error is negative, like in this case, it is minus 0.03 millimeter. Then the correction would be plus 0.03 millimeter because it's measuring less. In this case, the error is 0.02 millimeter. So the since correction will be minus 0.02 mm. Because in this case, it's measuring more. So we need to subtract that extra. Now coming to the device. In this device, what is the error? Let's see that. Okay. Now when you move the circular scale over the main scale, till you hear this clicking sound, you will observe. Now move this circular scale over the main scale till you hear the clicking sound. Now as you see, it shows an division 6. It shows 5 divisions below the 0. Just see. This is 0, and the number of divisions which are below 0 coinciding with the main scale is 5. Just see this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and the 5th one. This is the division. That means in our instrument, the error is minus because 0 is to the right side. Okay. So least count 0 error, minus 0.05 millimeter, 0 correction, 0.05 millimeter with a positive sign. So that means you have to change the sign to positive. Now coming to the reading. Take this wire and fit it between the screw heads. Don't press the wire too hard, because it happens with students, they are taking it carelessly, they press it too hard. It should not be done because you will deform the wire. Again, rotate till you hear the clicking sound. After that, how do we take the reading? Now, first of all, see the main scale reading. Main scale reading is 0. You can see that it is still at 0. It has not moved beyond that. The only reading that you will get will be on the circular scale. Against the main scale reading, which is the best coinciding division happens to be, 27th division is the best coinciding division with the main scale. See, 25, 26, 27th division is the best coinciding one. So once again, the main scale reading is 0 because it's not showing any reading there. And the best coinciding division against the main scale that we see is 25, 26, 27. So we record it in the table. Main scale reading 0. Circular scale division 27. The N into LC, N means number of division into the least count, which is 0.01 millimeter, so 0.27 mm. And the total reading, main scale reading plus circular scale reading will be 0.27 millimeter. So now we repeat the same process by moving the wire position between keeping it here. No need to rotate because it's so thin that I don't think you'll be able to make out what rotation. So just change the position of the wire. Change the location and take the reading again. If the wire is of uniform thickness, the value of the diameter will be maybe just a little different from what you have already taken. And once again, this way. So, keep on changing the position and take about 4 to 5 readings. Like this. Then change the position once again. So every time you must hear the clicking sound. Do not operate the screw gauge with this screw. It's very wrong. You will incorporate more error than it actually has. Always use a ratchet and rotate it like this. Thank you. The mean value of the diameter will be mean value, which you calculate from here, plus minus the zero error. See, in all these readings, we have not yet incorporated the zero error. So we will do that at the end. So find out the mean value, then plus the plus whatever error that is there. That would be your result and the necessary precautions and sources of error.